All right, at this time, our keynote speaker is a former amateur boxer. He enlisted in the United States Army to proudly serve his country. After the service, he became a trainer, manager, and promoter, putting on shows all over the state of Florida and actually around the globe. He served as councilman and mayor of the city of Hialeah. He was inducted into the Florida Boxing Hall of Fame in 2015. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your keynote speaker this evening, Mr. Julio Martinez.
I wish I would have had these many people all my fights. First of all, it's a point of privilege. I would like to ask all of the people here that have served in the United States Armed Forces, please stand. Without you, we may not be here today. So I want to thank you all from the bottom of my heart. I was one of them, by the way. Hoorah! If you have read the program, I started in boxing 68 years ago. I will be 76 years old next Wednesday. I would like to ask for a moment of silence for those who have passed in the boxing world, especially my good friend, Dr. Alan Fields, who just passed a few days ago. Let's have a moment of silence for them, please. Thank you very much. I want to read a few things until they tell me to get off of here or before that. I started in boxing when I was 8 years old, and you saw it in the program, in Mantilla, La Habana, Cuba. I lived two blocks away from a training gym where folks that you probably know, Luis Manuel Rodriguez, Douglas Vallan, Florentino Fernandez, and others used to train at that gym. When we came to the United States, my love of boxing never ended. I graduated, well, I actually didn't graduate. I went to Miami Jackson High School, right across the street from Caron's gym, where Juan Arroyo used to train. He's here tonight, and he's going to become one of the recipients of the Boxing Hall of Fame tomorrow. There, I continued my boxing career. I fought many times, but the Army called. Vietnam started, Bay of Pigs invasion. I quit high school and went into the Army. I thought I was going to go to Bay of Pigs. They sent my tail to the 25th Infantry Division in Schofield Barracks. From there, everyone would go to Vietnam. I was lucky. I came back alive. I drove for a general there, and at my table, we have two other folks that are also in the Army, Chico Rivas and his son-in-law, Marine and an Army guy just like me. Thank you very much. After the service, during the service, I boxed in the Army there. I had 39 amateur fights. I got beat up most of the time, but it didn't matter. I wasn't a good boxer, but I learned a lot. The thing that I learned most in the Army, discipline, and never underestimate the opponent. That has continued with me for the rest of my life. And I have had good success of whatever I did because I followed those two principles. Today I was at one of the seminars with Steve Canton. And you know, I love what you said, Steve, about the old school. The old school in training of boxing. The old school or no school at all. What we're doing today in training and boxing is not what I learned And I think that we should go back to the old school. When I opened up my first boxing gym in the city of Hialeah, I had a great guy living in my gym. He didn't have a nickel in his pocket. When I found out about it, I brought him to my gym, Kid Gavilan. He was incredible training our kids and teaching them about life. I buried him a few years ago. I helped pay for his funeral. That guy taught me so much about boxing, even more than Luis Manuel Rodriguez, who I've known all my life. Gerardo Gonzalez, Kid Gavilan, will never be forgotten. He fought over 140 times, never got knocked out. Fought Sugar Ray Robinson, fought the best in the world, and he never got knocked down. Got knocked down, I think, 3 or 4 times, but never knocked out. I promoted my very first boxing event at Hialeah's Mylander Auditorium after I had 2 of them in my own warehouse. The biggest one was that I can remember at that place was Jose Rivalta. Got knocked out by an unknown kid from Puerto Rico. He underestimated him. Jose Rivalta was the best fighter in those days in the heavyweight division. He got knocked down by someone that should have never even been in the ring with him. So underestimate your enemy, never. Don't ever do that. I could go on and on, but I just want to thank people that helped me to get to where I got in life, especially in the world of boxing. I've promoted all over the world, but I owe it to all these people I'm about to mention. And forgive me if I forget someone. I'm old and I forget. Enrique Encinosa, one hell of a guy. I see him almost every day. We work at the same radio station sometimes, and we talk about nothing but boxing. He was one of my mentors besides the great, great Chris Dundee. I carried a bucket at Miami Beach Convention Center a few times for him, especially when I saw a couple of boys fight there Miami Beach Convention Center was the start of boxing for the state of Florida, I think, and Chris Dundee and Angelo Dundee were there for me. They taught me a lot also. But let me see where my names are at. Kiki Lamelas, most of you probably don't know him. He was a great amateur in Cuba. He came and fought. He was this tall, but he had a heart of a lion. Chico Rivas, my friend for 28, 30 years, helped me so much. Him and Norman Wilson when I had my gyms in Hialeah. Dr. Fields, may he rest in peace. Dr. Garcia Septien, another great doctor. He went on to become a good, well-known man in boxing with the WBC. Ben Lonick, he showed me how to build a ring from Homestead. Johnny Torres from Homestead also. Steve Canton, who already mentioned, Steve helped me so much. We had a lot of fun there in Punta Gorda when I used to bring my fighters. I was learning how to promote. Henry Ribalta. I was the one that started him in boxing. He owned a boxing gym on Southwest A Street. I told him, why don't you start promoting? And he did. And he stayed around. He's still around with the Seminole Indians at the Hard Rock Hotel. My friend Don King, one heck of a guy. Sarvelio del Valle, my good friend, may he rest in peace. Johnny Torres, by the way, knocked out Pedro Laza, who underestimated Johnny Torres, right in Hialeah. Luis de Cubas, who's worked with me, and we created together the greatest team that I feel in boxing here in the state of Florida, Team Freedom. We stole all those fighters from Castro. We had 15 fighters. We actually didn't steal them. They decided to defect, and they knew that Hialeah's Julio Martinez would take them on and try to make them big stars in the boxing world, and we did. There's a young man, because he's younger than I am, and he helped me so much. And I can't forget the day that they used my boxing ring for the Aaron Pryor Arguello fight at the Orange Bowl. None other than Mr. Walter Alvarez and Ramiro Ortiz. Walter, stand up. You can stand up, Walter. I'm older than you are, and I stand up. Don Kahn from Puerto Rico. We have a lady here sitting at my table. Well, I'm sitting at her table. Duran's daughter. Get up, lady. She's in television all the time, and she's been a friend for years and years, just like her father was to me. We had a good time together many times. At the Seville Hotel, one night, I went nuts like I usually do, and I promoted a fight New Year's Eve. I had Roberto Duran and Mr. Bolo Punch himself, Kid Gavilan, as my guest that night, and we filled the place at the Seville Hotel. New Year's Eve, by the way. Jorge Rubio, who was inducted last month, he couldn't make it. He's going to be inducted tomorrow. Jorge Rubio, where are you? My good friend. The first job he got, we helped him get in training here in the United States. My good friend, a former Hialeah cop, my friend for life, Bill Connors. I'm getting to the end. Carlos Albuerne, he was best known for punching somebody out in the middle of an event in Hialeah, my land auditorium. Mandy DeWiz Fernandez, I was with him last week at Dr. Fields' funeral. He's not here tonight. He's a hell of a guy. Dr. Dave Hutchison, my partner in the boxing world for many years. He's a great gentleman, too. Tutico Zavala, you know, we were always competing in boxing, but we were friends, him and his father. I know he's not doing well, but they helped me a lot, too. We helped each other. Pat Burns. Don Hazelton, may he rest in peace. I even did a fight in Tallahassee at his request. I never forget that. Many, many more. I know I'm running out of time, and you know, I just want to end this way. There's no one in this room that has been hit harder than me. 5 years ago, I died. I got hit by a car on I-95, and I didn't pass out. Incredible. So don't tell me about being getting hit hard. I just want to wind up tonight by saying that the best fight that I have ever witnessed in my career as a promoter was the one between Christy Martin and Belinda Laracuente in Las Vegas. What a fight. And thank you very much for having me here tonight. God bless you all.